All right, this is Mr. Knight, Geometry, Chapter 1.4, Measure and Classify Angles. So let's get started. If you remember an angle that is between 0 degrees and 90 degrees, we call that acute. Angles that are exactly 90 degrees, we call it right, and you always know that by that little square symbol. Obtuse angles are angles that are greater than 90 but less than 180. Those are obtuse. And then you have what's called a straight angle, which is exactly 180 degrees, okay? Here's another postulate. It's called the angle addition postulate. So it's very similar to the segment addition postulate, but it just says that if you have angle 1 plus angle 2, together they make angle 3, basically. So typically, when you're solving problems like that, you'll be given the overall angle, and they'll give you one of the angles in degrees, and then you have to solve for that last one, okay? So let's see what's next here. Find an angle measurement, so let's do one. So given that the measure of angle LKN, so that's LKN, so that whole angle is 145 degrees. It said find LKM. LKM, let's use a different color, let's use red. LKM, and you need to find MKN, MKN. So where's my purple? Oop. Sorry about that. And then you need to find this angle right here. So if I know that 2x plus 10, which represents this angle, plus 4x minus 3, which represents that angle, is equal to 145, then you should be able to solve for x. So let's just go ahead and do that real quick. I have 2x plus 10, all right? And all that's going to be plus 4x minus 3. 4x minus 3, and all that equals 145, right? So if we combine the x's, that gives me 6x, right? If we combine the constants, that gives me 7. It's a negative 7, or positive 7, so let's move 7 over to the right-hand side. So at that point, I have 6x is equal to 138, and if I divide both sides by 6, therefore I have x is equal to 23. Now that I have the x value, I can plug that back in to actually find what LKM is. So let's plug that 23 back into this, and I have 2 times 23 plus the 10. Okay, it's going to be equal to 56 plus the 10 is 56 degrees. So I know this is 56 degrees. So then you have two options. You can plug the 23 back into that x and solve for m, the measure of mkn, or you can just say 145 degrees, take away the 56, and you can actually solve that angle, okay? One thing you need to remember, when we talk about when we identify angles, we identify it, that's just the identification of the angle, and with the little m, which means measure, that's actually a degree value. So when we talk about angles are the same or equal to each other, we use the term congruent and the symbol congruent. When we talk about the measure of an angle is equal to another measure of an angle, we use the term equal to with the equal sign. Okay. All right, let's see what's next. So angle bisector, this is identical to the segment bisector. If you remember the segment bisector, you had a segment and you had a point, a line, or a plane that split that segment into two equal parts where we'll call that B, C, and D, where BC is congruent to CD, all right, those line segments. So angle bisector works the exact same way. You have an angle right here, which we're going to call that angle XYZ. And then if YW is an angle bisector, the ray YW is an angle bisector, then I know that angle XYW is congruent to angle WYZ, okay? So that concludes our measuring and classifying angles. Have a beautiful day, and we'll see you tomorrow.